Hi everyone, welcome to National Treasures. I'm Nick Angiers. Last time in our show we looked at Chinese archery, which had a very important role in ancient China, and even Confucius taught archery to his disciples. Today, I'm going to tell you about something called a shuai jiao, or Chinese wrestling. Shuai jiao literally means to throw onto the ground using one's legs, with leg grapples being a prominent technique. The earliest form of shuai jiao goes back almost 5,000 years. In a sport called jiao di, or headbutting, people would wear horned helmets, sort of like Viking helmets, and ram each other. According to legend, in about 3000 BC, the Yellow Emperor's army used these horned helmets to impale the soldiers of their enemy Churyo's army. Then came jiao li in the Zhou Dynasty, 12th to 3rd century BC, part of the Zhou army training curriculum, along with archery and military strategy. By this time, it was a grappling martial art with sophisticated techniques like strikes, blocks, joint locks, and pressure points. Jiao Li is among the oldest systematic martial arts in the world. By the Qin Dynasty, 221 to 206 BC, Jiao Li had become a spectator sport. Matches were held to entertain the court as well as to select the best fighters to serve as imperial bodyguards or martial arts instructors for the imperial army. These competitions were held on a leitai, or striking platform, an elevated fighting arena with no railings. Some leitai tournaments could last for up to a week, in which hundreds or even thousands of fighters would participate. Soldiers learned jiao li throughout Chinese history, and jiao li particularly enjoyed popularity among the Manchu military of the Qing Dynasty, which had a large influence on the development of later Chinese martial arts. The term shuai jiao first came into official usage in 1928 when the Central Guoshu Academy standardized the rules. Today, it's still very popular with Mongol communities who hold shuai jiao competitions during festivals like Naram. Of course, the Mongolian version of shuai jiao has its own characteristics and in the Mongol language is called bouke. There are also a few other styles, like Beijing style, which is essentially the style developed and used by the Manchu Imperial Guards Brigade during the Qing Dynasty. Tianjin style is a combination of Manchu and Ming Dynasty shuai jiao with tripping and using the forearms to block and strike. And Xinjiang style, developed from numerous Turkic styles of wrestling with lots of waist techniques. Well, that's all for now. Next time we'll be looking at pushing hands, a type of training routine related to Taijiquan. Thanks for watching.